Hi, I'm Sybrand Dijkstra and I'm the proud founder of DJ Studio. And I've got something cool for you. We have DJ Studio version 3.0. And 3.0 is a giant leap for us in history. A small setting. If you go to the settings over here, you see the Beatgrid, auto, fixed or AI. So when you put it on auto, we will Beatgrid your tracks automatically. We will detect if your Beatgrid is fixed or that you have old disco songs or other genres of music where the tempo is flexible and we need AI to find every beat. Let me show it to you. I'm on an empty database and let's add some tracks to my mix. Here we go. Now we analyze every track and we see, is it possible to make a fixed Beatgrid or do we need to make an AI Beatgrid? And here you see the tempo of the tracks. And these tempos all look fixed, but there are some spikes in here. And those gray lines is the actual tempo of the tracks. Let me start by Whitney Houston and switch on the track information over here. And we see for Whitney Houston, we have a fixed Beatgrid. And switch on the metronome. By the way, the metronome has a volume now. So this is how you can set the volume of the metronome. This track is fine. Madonna. It's an AI Beatgrid. When you remove the line, you see there are small spikes. So Madonna was almost perfect on the beat. 50 cents. AI Beatgrid. That's good. The Tramps, Disco Inferno. Weeha, Disco Inferno. And you see the tempo changes in here. No problem for us. James Hype. Fixed Beatgrid. Wild Cherry. AI Beatgrid. And you see this is recorded analog. Let's see. Fixed, no problem. Sex is on fire, also no problem. David Guetta, fixed of course, Murder on the Dance Floor. So cool, Diplo. Fixed, no problem. And then we see Timmy Trumpet. There is something strange with this Beatgrid. Well, that is because there are different tempos in this track. Have a listen. 128. 150. We put it on AI because it's not fixed. Fixed would make it one line and that's not right. What would Rekordbox do? Interesting, I imported it from Rekordbox. Okay, so Rekordbox says this is fixed and then it's halved. And maybe it's doubled, so this part is 150. Well, the AI is almost right, but we have a second option and that's AI Flex. And with AI Flex, we try to find the flexibility in a track. Have a look, AI Flex. So it's crunching now and woohoo! This is cool, this is really cool. So have a listen what's going on over here. So you see the tempo is going up and with our AI, we're perfectly able to follow this. And why would you follow this break? Well, suppose I like to have this drum and bass. And I like to drum over the break because I hate breaks. I want to keep on dancing. So I extracted, by the way, let's have a listen solo what this is. And here we go. So this is the drum and the bass of the track over there. And now let's have a listen. So here is my drum. Woohoo! So this is where you can use AI Flex. So this is making your life a lot easier that we already do the beat gridding for you. Another thing we have is the effects block. And the effects block is really nice. You can find it under effects, of course, and here is the effects pack. In this block, you see lots of effects and you can test these effects without adding the automation to the tracks immediately. So let's have a look at Murder on the Dance Floor. And let's say there is this gator or flanger gator. I like the gator. We have an XY pad in here. And the cool thing is you can wang it. And with wanging, I mean you can touch the knobs without destroying your mix. Have a look. So I can, on the horizontal line, the X, I can operate the gator, and when I go up or down, I'll operate the filter. That's when you're playing. So let's do a reverb in here. And you see, I didn't add any automation in here. But now there's something really cool. What if I press this while I'm not playing? Well, then I can add automation. Have a look. So I press this button, and when I go with the slider, you see my gator going up and down. And this is a little effect block. So we have local automation in here. I have the main line, the gator line, and I have the second line over here. And that's the filter. So you see, I can add the filter and I can add the gator. So zooming in over here, you see the lines. I can get this line and set the gator to a time of 1. Let's zoom a little bit with the Z. Here's my gator, and this gator can run up, and maybe the filter, let's put it in the middle in here and let it run up a bit like this as well, or maybe this way and then coming down. So let's have a listen now. So, switch off the metronome. And maybe this one should go down over here as well. Okay, the effect is good, but the position was wrong. Well, the cool thing with effect blocks is that you can grab them and you can move them. So I can move it exactly to this point. And maybe a bit less filter. Okay, so this is an effect block. This effect block can be placed everywhere. So if you want to have it in a transition, fine, let's put it in a transition. Another interesting thing with the effect blocks is that you can save them. So when you right-click the effect, you can save this effect block. And let's call this my gate builder. You'll see it now at the presets. And when I click over here and I want to have another gate builder, click, and here is another gate builder. And my gate builder is now in here. And a bit too late. Let's go over here. Woohoo! And then there's another cool way to get your automation into your playlist, and that's by recording what you do. So let's go over here. Grab the phaser, everybody's favorite effect. And I'd like to have this in my set. Well, I'll place the cursor where I want to start recording, or a little bit before, and I press the record button. And then the playhead becomes red and everything you touch on the automation gets recorded. Have a look. If you think you're getting away, I will prove you wrong. And you see, boy, just come along. Hear me when I say, hey. And here is my recording. This is what I did. I can have a listen. And you see what we did over here. And you can shorten this if you want. You see, we're pretty flexible in it, or make it longer. And of course, place it on the position where you want to have this all favorite phaser. Hey, and it's not only this track, eh? If you like the gate builder over here, and select the gate builder, and here you have your gate builder. So you can basically create any favorite build-up or drop-a-later, add it to your presets and use it in your mixes really fast. How cool is that? But there's more. We have the new Automix. So let's add some tracks in here. Add another 30 tracks to make it more interesting. So I've got some tracks in here and we have Automix. Automix, Automix. Automix is gone. Yes, Automix is gone. It's called Harmonize now. And why do we call it Harmonize? Well, a lot of DJs, they started cursing when they heard the word DJ Studio and Automix. We don't want to have auto mixing. We're the DJs, of course. And we create our own mixes. We create our own transitions. True. But DJ Studio is a DAW for DJs and we help you order your playlist harmonically and on tempo. So that's the only thing we do. We don't do the mixing for you. That's what you do yourself. The only thing we do, we set some transition presets for you. So I'd like to do the bass swap. I love the bass swap and just place it somewhere on the tracks and help me order my track list. But there's more. We've got Harmonize in the old way. And in the old way, we impressed you by a shitload of mix combinations that we made. And depending on your machine, in 15 seconds, I reckon 267 million mix combinations. That's what we did. It was a little bit brute forcing, and we did a pretty good job. There was one track over here that we had an issue with, and one track over here, and the rest is pretty compatible. But there's Harmonize 2. Harmonize 2 is AI. And with AI, this new model, have a look. One, two, oh, here we are. And we have a nice combination. Waiting, well, that's one that's not fitting. Well, let's try Harmonize again. Maybe it comes up with something different. And here we are. And now we have Disco Inferno. That's not a fit. And the Kalinka at the end. So you see, with the new Harmonize, you simply press the button, Harmonize it for me, and we come up with a new solution until you like what you see. So this is the real super fast new harmonizing of your playlist. And then we've got another really nice feature in 3.0, and that's the integration with Loopcloud. Loopcloud is a service where you can get a subscription to get samples. And they have a few cool things. The first thing, they supplied a free sample pack. So if you go to the samples over here and you see the sample pack, simply click download and the pack gets downloaded and gets analyzed and you can use these samples for free in your mix. So you see some groups in here. I've got the vocals. Ha, 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 ha. And if I like this vocal, I'll drag it over here and put it in front of my eye. Here we go. So that's one way you can use these samples. Another way you can use it is for some drum loops. And no, the garage. I like this house drums too. And I can grab the house drums in here. Okay, there's too much energy in there. Let's see if we put it in here. Let's put it over here. So here we go and repeat it because there are loops. If you think you're getting away. So this is a way, and this is a nice one. And there are lots of samples in here. Another cool thing is Loopcloud. They have a VST And this VST is a special VST that we combined in all versions of DJ Studio. So you don't need to have the ultimate version to get access to the Loopcloud VST, since it's an instrument and it's serving samples. So when you click this button, you will see that the Loopcloud app opens. If you don't have the Loopcloud app, no worries. We have a discount code for you where you can try Loopcloud for free and see if it is a fit for you. It's nice if you want to make your own mashups and you want to spice up your track. They have lots of samples. You can search in here. Let's look for some loops, melodic techno. And the loops you see in here are all playable. They can play along in the tempo of your track. So when I play my track in here and I select it, okay, so let's say this is a drum loop that I like, then I can simply select this drum loop and drag it into DJ Studio. Well, at the moment you drag it, you get a shitload of credits every month that you can use. This loop is gonna cost me 2 credits, so I'll buy the loop. And now when I drag it again into DJ Studio, you will see that the loop is dropped in here. And here is the loop. I can extend it. I can place it in the correct position. And now, and there is my loop perfectly in the tempo synchronized to my Murder on the Dance Floor. So you see, we built lots of new stuff in DJ Studio 3.0, and I hope you have a lot of fun with it.